Good morning, ducks! Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the Duck Adventure for August the 4th. Oh, I'm tired, man. I slept in. The ducks woke me up here in the yard. It's loud. It's about 25 after 5 right now. It's unbelievably warm. The ducks are wandering up. They're pacing the pen. I stayed up way too late last night trying to find a snapper to the cage, which I really hope that company in the States comes through and helps us out with a little more reasonable shipping charge than $350. Okay, Dougie's at the gate here. Dougie, you're all excited. I'm gonna open the big gate. Oh, I'm half asleep here. That poor little duck I found last night. I don't know where it is. It's in the barn. It's not out here with the rest. Oh, boys. I got too much going on here. Mosquitoes just found me. Okay, Doug, what's going on here? You know, Doug is doing a lot of barking now. I think he thinks something's here. It's just crazy. There's no order at all. They're nuts here. This it's absolutely crazy. I'm half asleep too. Man, staying up last night was like 11:30. This poor little duck. Its foot is totally destroyed. I'm gonna have to put it out of its misery. But I'm going to freeze its body. And then I'm going to, we're gonna get a trap. Hold. Okay, I'm getting eaten alive here, guys. I gotta go get my jacket. It's so hot, I came out without a jacket on. This is so nice. But I'm getting eaten alive. And the mosquito bracelet doesn't work, guys. It's funny. I had it on, and the mosquito landed right beside it and bit me. Like, right beside me. It was unbelievable. I looked down, and the mosquito was like an inch away from the bracelet feeding on me. Now I'm instantly hot. As soon as I put the jacket on, I overheated. That's how warm it is. It's crazy. Yeah, that poor little snapping turtle duck. But, you know, I'm going to deal with it. I'm going to do something. Oh, look at this. We're wasting no time leaving. Oh, there's a happy dog. Doug, doing your job. Last night, guys, it was like 10 o'clock, and he was out here laying in the swamp watching us. I couldn't believe it last night. Because usually, Doug, you know, once you lock the ducks up, he's on the back deck wanting in. And last night, he was like down here, actually right down here where I'm standing, watching the swamp. See, the thing is, he saw the coyotes, eh? That's the trick. Once he sees them, he's like, okay, they're here. Even though I shot it. Do you want a drink, Doug? He nudged my hand. As soon as I turned the hose on here, he was rumping into me. I was talking on the camera and he was pushing against me. Yeah, they're going down to the water. Oh, I'm tired, guys.
But then again, I've only had like 5 hours sleep. And it's going to be another brutal hot day today again. Today, the internet last night before I went to bed, I checked, big red banner across. Severe heat warning. Because yesterday it was crazy. Like, I couldn't believe it, you know. We walk out of the house and it feels like you open up the oven door.
I gotta do the water here, guys. They come home just to use me. He's dead. He just casually goes over and smells them. Well, he certainly broke up the feeding frenzy. Oh, Dougie.
All right, I gotta do some chores here. And then go have my coffee. And we're going on a road trip first thing this morning. I gotta go get that straw before it gets too hot. And drop that part off at my neighbor's place to fix my tractor. Oh, I don't believe that. Well, a nice wind picked up and took all the mosquitoes away. It was pretty crazy there at one point. Ducks.
Relaxing. Oh, there's Discos. Hello, Disco Duck.
Yeah, little rascal, yeah.
My two little guys that I found the other day that are crosses, I haven't seen them in 2 days, actually. I haven't seen them since I tagged them. They'll reappear. They always do. They just all of a sudden bang. They're in your face. Come home just to have a nap. Man, I don't know what it is about staying on the water at night and then coming here during the day. Doug's, oh man, it's so cool watching him work. He just constantly looking. Best thing that happened is for him to see a coyote. Now he thinks they're here all the time. There you go. Just checking around, doing the, he's like a mall security guard. You know? Checking the stores, making sure the doors are locked. Move along, kids. No loitering here. Oh, Dougies.
And then he comes over and pushes against me for a rub. What a dog. I'm going for a coffee, guys. I want to get my edits done. And we're going on a road trip to get some straw. And I get back here. Don't know what's going to happen with this heat wave. Oh, I'm so mad that I didn't get to do any pen work yesterday. I tried. I came outside. I'm not kidding you. Like, it was so hot. The heat, even with my hat on, I could feel it baking through to my brain. Not the kind of day you want to be out here, especially out in the open here where there's no shade building the pen.
But we're so close. So close. Oh, man. I could taste the victory of being done here.
Tomorrow is supposed to be a lot cooler. Like 26, 27 tomorrow. So I can whack up a whole bunch of wire. All right, I'm going to go and have my breakfast and have a coffee and get my edit done.
Another thing, too, I've noticed is... I'm back, guys. I'm sorry. I looked over my shoulder, and there's next to no ducks at the feeder. It's not even like they're eating a meal. Because, you know, really, like, when ducks are locked up in the pen, they'll literally eat a half a pound of feed a night each. But they're not eating that much right now. They're not that hungry when they're coming back home. They're coming in for more like a snack before bed, you know. They're not really having a meal because, I'm not kidding you, the feeding rush lasts 10 minutes.
And if they were truly hungry, as in like, you know, they hadn't eaten all night, they, with that feeding frenzy, I would have to throw a bag of food down on the ground because it would be, you know, a half an hour, 40 minute feeding frenzy. But, you know, they don't even, I'm blown away how little they're eating compared to what they should be. But if they were locked in the pen all night, be a different story. We'd be burning through, right now, we'd be burning through like probably 5 bags a night, which right now we're burning through 3 bags a day.
He's working.
Dougie. Laying there watching his ducks. I'm so amazed with this dog this year. It has made my life so much easier considering I'm slacking and not getting the pen done. What's the temperature? 22. It's gonna be a hot day.
Hi, Dougie. You watching your ducks? Like, this is what the ducks do. They come back and they just sleep here. I think it's something to do with safety. They come back here during the day to be safe. Well, to have a snack and be safe. But like, the yard is just full of ducks relaxing. You know, they're hanging around the water coolers. Doing nothing after a hard night of partying on the lake.
You know, like, why aren't they at the lake right now? Like, you know, I don't understand it. Unless it is nap time right now. Which most of them are napping, actually. It's really quiet. Actually, that's what happens here. They come back and the yard goes silent. They're so cute. Almost done my edit. Gonna have my breakfast and then we're going on a road trip. And hopefully I can get bearings today when I'm in town for the electric motor.
I'm gonna leave you in the garage, Doug.
I don't believe how hot it is, guys. Well, put it this way. It's 9:15 and the ducks left. They're back at the lake. There's not a duck. Well, there's, you know, maybe, I'm trying to think here. Not think, but count here. There's like maybe 25. Oh, not even. Well, maybe 30 ducks. Actually, the geese are even gone.
Well, the Muscovies are here, of course. And this small group of ducks is here. But that's it. Like, look at guys. The yard is absolutely barren. And I was on the clothesline stand hanging my laundry. And I got a glimpse of them swimming down a lake. Swim down a lake. Yeah, my lake. Down the lake. But they're nowhere to be found. They're gone. Like, you can't see them anywhere on the lake.
I'm thinking they went farther down. Because I don't even see them across the lake. Haven't heard back yet from that company about the snapping turtle traps. I sent off another email this morning to the owners of the company because they actually have the owners' emails listed. So I'm hoping I'm hoping they come through. We got to get some cages here to catch these guys. Some traps, I mean. I'm not liking it at all. This is worse than coyotes. Put it that way. The snapping turtles are worse than coyotes. They have to be dealt with. So there might be a big addition to the GoFundMe page, guys. If we can't get something happening here, just to the shipping cost to get them here is crazy. And I need a proper trap because the homemade ones, guys, I don't have time to build a trap because I'm trying to get the pen done. And if I, you know, wait till I get the pen done, we could be like 2 more weeks of losing a duck a day. Minimum a duck a day that we know about.
These guys are totally chilling in the shade. There's a bunch of them in the barn. But Dougie, I'm gonna leave you at home.
It's far, far too hot to bring him in the truck today. Because I gotta go to Roberts, stop at the welding shop, drop the tire off. Oh, the tire off, I don't believe this. And I had to order the bearing off of eBay, but there's a guy in Montreal selling the bearings for the electric motors. For the electric motor for the boat, it was like $6. You know, so I bought two of them. Well, actually, it was $7 for two. And they're coming from Montreal. Nobody in town had any. Oh, it's not as hot yet as yesterday, but that's in the sun right now. It's 37. 37. At 9:30 in the morning. Sorry, that can't be right.
Yeah, 9:15 is what the time is exactly, guys.
I'm going to fill up the water here just in case the ducks do return. I don't think they're going to return. I think they're gone. I'm going on a road trip. We'll get the straw, do all that kind of neat stuff, get back here. And then I'll do my edit this afternoon at a sticky desk. I wanted to come down and check here. The fact that I couldn't see any ducks in the yard, I was a little worried. Well, I wouldn't say I'm totally worried, but I know they're down here because, like, where could 700 ducks just disappear to? Oh, look at them. They're all in the shallows here. Well, there's not 700 right there. I see a whole bunch down at the far end, like right at the far end. It's too bad I didn't bring the big camera, I could have zoomed in. But they were just swimming around here because the water is really murky. It's all chewed up, but still, that's not 700 ducks.
There's got to be a bunch over there. They're scattered all over the lake. All right, I got to go on a road trip. Oh, there's our Canada geese. Hopefully when I get back, those people at the tomahawk turtle trap place will have gotten back to me. Oh, I hope they help us out. Because they're not that expensive. Like, they're like $110. I've bought much more expensive things with the duck adventure. It's the shipping charge that's just through the roof. There's got to be a cheaper way of getting them here other than FedEx. All right, on a road trip. It's almost 30 degrees in the shade inside the pen here. And it's only, well, now it's 9:30. I think it's going to be a lot hotter than they're saying it's going to be. Well, look at Doug. He's already got his tongue hanging out. And all he did was casually walk to the lake and back with me. Doug, you're going to go in the garage. Nice and cool in there. I'll be the one who suffers on the road trip. Come on. I know you want to go with me, but if you had opposing thumbs and could drive, I'd send you on the road trip. There you go. Enjoy the cool, comfortable garage. Yeah, like it's 23 in here. It's 10 degrees cooler. I'll be back. Doug has no idea how lucky he is. It is so hot. Whew. All right, let's cook ourselves and go get a whole bunch of stuff. Well, guys, I need 6 more patio stones for the pen. Oh, she's warm today. Thankfully, I'll have Doug at home. I think we gotta go around to the other side. Not much straw left.
I'll come by the next week, tail end of the week.
I just got home and there's next to no ducks still in the yard. Well, there's a little bit over there. Oh, some geese are back. When I was driving on the highway, there's just a ton of them down at the other end of the lake. I couldn't slow down because there was a bunch of cars behind me. But let's get Dougie. I think it's like almost 4 o'clock. I've been gone the whole day. I can't believe how much running around I had to do. Dougie? How are you, Doug? Oh, you're nice and cool. How are you ever, Dougie? Oh, you're really dusty too. Oh, Dougs, I'm home. You have no idea how lucky you are today, Doug. It was brutally hot, brutally hot. You slept all day, didn't you? I wonder if the chipmunk was in here and that's what Doug was doing, because when I came in, I heard something digging at this corner. Dougie, were you chasing a chipmunk in here? I'm home. Bad news on my tractor. My neighbor, who's the welder, who couldn't weld anything, he's got a full welding shop. Can't fix the he can, but he says it'll be like 5-6 hours labor because it's cast iron, and so I got to see what it's going to cost to order the part. Plus he was telling me how tricky it is to weld cast iron, and then he says, you know, even though he could weld it all back together and it'd be like probably about 5 hours to do everything, that it won't be near as strong, and chances are it might even break again because of the torque. So I've got to go on the internet and find out if I can order this part, or find a part, or used one, or something. But he said that it's a real trick. There's lots of special techniques to welding cast iron. And then he said that he's going to, basically every bolt hole will get filled up with weld, and I will have to re-drill and tap everything, he says, which will be really tricky because cast iron is not the easiest to do. So that was that part of my adventure today. Yes, Doug, I know, I'm home. I'm sorry. Well, it's 20 to 4. So you were alone for 6 hours. Oh, no, Doug. Oh, big kisses. Dougie. I know, 6 hours, eh? That's a lot of separation. All right, we got to unload the truck. And then I still have to edit tonight's episode. I forgot my gravel pile's in the way to back the truck up to the barn to unload the straw. So that's going to be another trip. But I got to get the truck unloaded. I don't want to deal with it tomorrow because tomorrow the weather is supposed to be cooler and I'm going to work on the pen. That's the plan. Yeah, I really wish I could have stopped on the highway because I couldn't believe the amount of ducks at the other end of the lake. It was sort of neat driving on the highway and seeing all these white dots on the lake down there. This is all that's in the yard. Not much. It's quite pathetic, actually. But then again, it is brutally, brutally hot out. Not a lot of duck action here. All right, let's get the truck unloaded. Poor snapping turtle ducks. We got two of them now. Hurting ducks, man. I'm going to have to put some ducks down tomorrow. But these guys are due to come out and start running around the property. Maybe tomorrow I'll let them out. I just gave them water. I'm going to load the truck now. I think Doug is going to lay down again. Oh, look at this. Doug. I've been home 12 minutes, guys. 12 minutes, Doug, outside, and you're back in here laying down. It's hot out, I know. What a dog. Oh, Dougie. You went outside, ran down to the swamp, did a little bit of barking. Now you're back. Oh, you. My little baby dog. Oh, Dougie, I love you. But this just proves my point, guys. If I leave the garage door open, he's a slacker. 12 minutes, Doug, since I've let you out. And you're back in here. What a dog. Oh, there's our Canada geese, guys. The young one's got to start flying soon. There's a crazy storm blowing in. When I was at my last stop, they were telling me how there's a big weather warning on right now. Some big, big thunder showers coming. But there's a little bit of ducks at the creek there, so the rest of them are somewhere else on the lake. They just don't want to be home. They just don't want to be in the yard. Okay, I gotta unload this before the storm hits. Even though it's so hot right now, I'd like to do nothing, but I gotta get this done. Well, I'm getting it done just in time. Big crack of thunder and a bunch of lightning just started, so any moment it could start pouring. So I'm gonna unload these now, take them over to where the feeding station's gonna be. Oh, straw sneeze. All right, I'll get these unloaded. Now Doug's decided to be underneath my feet. Doug, I'm not going to leave you. I'm home for the day, you goof. I don't know if it's because of the storm, but more and more ducks are dribbling back to the yard. More and more keep appearing. Or it's because they heard me in the yard making noise, which is totally possible. There's a whole bunch over by the garden, and more are appearing in the swamp. I think it's because of the noise. I'm making noise and they come into the yard because the Canada geese appeared when I started making noise, which is bizarre. You'd think Canada geese would stay away from me, but I started banging things around here and, you know, unloading stuff, and all of a sudden, you know, everybody starts coming home.
There's like three times more ducks now than there was when I got home.
But I have to go have a shower. I can't believe it. All I did was unload the truck, move the patio stones, sweep out the back of the truck, and, you know, take my tire from the tractor out of the back of the truck, and which I gotta get that part. Oh, it sucks. And I'm absolutely just soaked. My laundry. I gotta take my laundry off. Oh, boys. I'll do that before it starts raining, which is just starting to drops now.
I'm doing an edit, and I checked my email. Well, I checked my email actually before I started my edit, and I have really good news. The company Tomahawk Turtle Traps, the owner, Greg, what an awesome company, guys. Remember I told you last night, yesterday's video, that the shipping was like $349 and, you know, the trap was $130. Well, they gave us a discount. The trap, they gave us 30% off, and he didn't recommend the trap that I found originally online. Actually, what somebody sent to me, they didn't recommend that one. He recommended a bigger one that's a multiple catch trap, and which he sent me the link to the video of it. It's exactly what we need. Like, you can catch like 6-7 turtles at once in it. So they gave us a 30% discount. And they got us, they gave us their Federal Express discounted shipping rate, $200 less, guys. So the grand total, I'm just waiting for the PayPal invoice from them to pay it. I think it's around like $210 or $229 US. Delivered right to the, right here, guys, right to the address, you know, the lake. So this is awesome news. And if I would have been here earlier and not running around town doing all my running around, it would have been shipped out today. But I didn't get it till after 5, since I got on my computer, actually. So it'll get shipped out on Monday. And it so Federal Express from him to me, we should have it by Friday, actually, because they're usually, Federal Express is pretty quick ground service. So that's the deal. I can't say enough good. I'm going to put the link to the company below the video. Right below the video, I'm going to put the link to the company, and send a thank you to Greg for helping us out, the owner. I can't believe the owner. He replied back, and he wanted to help us out, and he wanted to save ducks' lives, and what an awesome company. Put a big smile on my face. And, you know, we're saving some money big time, actually, because last night, I think the bill was, I think it was like $500 or $490 US, you know, down to like $230 US. Huge savings. Anyways, and we're going to get a trap that's better than the one that I looked at last night, and which was a link that somebody sent to me. Much better, actually. He highly recommended for our situation with the multiple turtles. So anyways, that'll be here this coming week. I'm excited, actually, because I just hate this snapping turtle thing, guys. Oh, man, you know, like I smoke the coyotes and get rid of that problem, and then, you know, everything's going smooth, but I can't protect the ducks in the water, and they want to be in the water, and I want them in the water. I want them to spend a ton of time down there, and the only way to do it is to get rid of the snapping turtles. And according to what he was telling me in the email, a lot of snapping turtles are potentially in the lake. A lot. They can overpopulate a lake. We might be shocked how many snapping turtles we catch. Like, seriously shocked. Anyways, so that's the good news that I got when I came in here and opened my email before I started my edit. So I got to get back to my edit now, but I wanted to share that with you because it's phenomenal news for the ducks. Oh, man, I can't wait to stop this carnage of the snapping turtle attacks on the poor ducks. So that's it. I got to get back to work here. I got to get this edit done because it's 7:15, and I don't think I'm going to get it up in time for tonight's for you to watch it, actually.
And don't forget to like the video and share it with your friends, and enjoy the show.